Hey YouTube, so today I decided to do a talk through video showing you guys my foundation routine. I'm gonna try my hardest to do this talk through. I usually avoid them because I have a 6-year-old and it's kind of hard filming videos when you have a little one running around. But he's watching a movie, so hopefully that'll keep him entertained long enough for me to talk to you guys, talk to whoever's watching, if anyone is watching. The first thing I do when I do my foundation or when I start my foundation is I moisturize my face. So that's what I'm gonna do. Add a little bit of moisturizer all over. All over the face, and the sun just went away. I think it's gonna rain, my luck. So excuse the lighting. I use natural lighting, so. It's not always the best when you live somewhere where it's constantly sunny, then raining, and then it's sunny again. Anyways, okay, so after the moisturizer, I'm gonna go ahead and use a primer, and I'm going to prime. I'm gonna list everything that I'm using down below. I usually prime just this area and my nose, just to kind of smooth away all those pores, my forehead. I like to focus it on my nose and this area just to cover up those pores. I use this stuff. It's really good. I really like it. And after that, I go in with MAC Prep and Prime, and I just use that on my T-zone. It keeps me from, well, not me, but it keeps my makeup from slipping and sliding. And I usually just put it here and on my nose. This is where I really get oily. So this really helps, you know, helps the oil. Duh. Okay, so now I can go in with my foundation. I got this lip balm from NYX, and it's really, really good. I got it on my Ipsy bag. So I am loving this thing. I've never tried it before. I tried their lipsticks and their lip glosses, but never their lip balms, and I really like it. It has like a slight tint, and it smells like cherries. So who doesn't like cherries? All right, then for the foundation, I'm going to go in with my MAC Match Master. I am in the color, 5.0? Yeah, 5.0. So I usually just get a little bit of that, just one pump on my fingers, and then I dab it all over. And this foundation is awesome. I'm pale right now, so it looks a little dark. But in the summer, it matched me perfectly. I might go back and just get a lighter color. But when I blend it out, it'll look good. Then I'm going to use a wet, just a beauty sponge. You can use your brush or your beauty blender or whatever you have. This is a sponge I got at Sally's and I love it. It works really well. So I'm gonna go ahead and just blend all of that into my face. And I like it because it looks really natural once everything is blended in. You could barely tell that I have foundation on. So I'm thinking about getting my eyebrows tattooed. This is something I've been debating for like years, and I think I'm doing it in the next couple of months. And I know what a lot of you are thinking when you think of eyebrow tattoos, that it's not what I'm doing. This is more what I have in mind. Isn't that better? See? I would just love to wake up with filled eyebrows every day. That would be awesome. And I'd have to fill them in. Filling in my brows is what takes me the longest. It's a pain in the ass. That's it. Nice and even. You could build up this foundation if you want full coverage. It's medium coverage and I really like it. I don't have a lot to cover up, but I like to just even out my skin tone. So after that, I go in with my concealer and I use the same sponge to blend that in. For today, I don't know, I'm debating between two. I really, really like this one from Maybelline. I have like two or three of these in my bathroom. They're really good. And I also like this one, the Select Cover Up from MAC. I think I'm gonna use this one today. This one is a little more drying, but you have to blend it out really fast. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna put a little bit on the back of my finger. And just pat that on there. You guys see that difference? Boom. Look at that nice bit. I hope this video isn't boring. I don't know. I feel like voiceovers are just way faster. But I like watching Tom Cruise. I don't know. Okay. I'm gonna use a little bit of that Maybelline. Just a little bit, just to highlight because it's lighter. I'm gonna put some here too. Okay, then I'm gonna go ahead and set that, but I left my setting powder in the bathroom, so I will be right back. Okay, now to set that, I'm gonna use this little brush right here, which I bought at, I think at CVS. It's like a double-ended brush. And this powder from Rimmel, which I really, really like. You guys can use whatever you have. So I set my under eye area. And my nose. And forehead. I don't get that oily on my chin. It's mainly my nose. So in order, it'll be my nose first, second, and third when it comes to oiliness. There we go. Okay, now I have to fill in my brows. I can't, you know, before I move on to the rest of the video, I mean, I'm almost done, but I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows because my brows look a hot mess, and I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. And as you can see, my eyebrows are filled in, and the difference, it's huge. It's a pretty big difference. Yeah. When I fill in my brows, it just frames my face. But anyways, now I'm going to go in with, I'm going to contour my nose. Just a little bit. Even though that has nothing to do with foundation, but this is a foundation video. I'm just gonna go ahead and contour my nose a little bit. I'm not gonna contour my cheeks because I just don't want to. I'm just not in the mood today. Today I'm gonna contour my nose. There we go. Now for my cheeks, I'm going to use this MAC 107 brush. This is a foundation brush, but it works. I mean, I love it for blush and bronzer. Now for highlights, I'm going to use this one in Tiki from Hard Candy. And I'm going to use this e.l.f. Stipple brush, the mini one. I love e.l.f. brushes. They're really affordable, but they're really good. I have another one. I have like their flat top kabuki one, and that's great for foundation and powders. I really, really like it. I'm gonna wipe off the same brush that I used for the blush. And I'm going to use that same brush for the bronzer. And I'm just gonna bronze my face a little bit. Just to have some color, because I'm pretty pale. Right now. And that's it. That's it for my foundation routine. Just let my hair down. Let's fix the hair. My hair has been up all day. I literally just let it down from this morning. That's how I sleep. I put like a little thing on and then I put my hair up like this in a pineapple. And that's it. But yeah, I'm getting off topic. Okay, so after the face is done, I almost forgot, I just spray my face. This is the Urban Decay, what do you call this? The Oil Control Makeup Setting Spray. Just go ahead and put that all over. Just bathe in it. And that's it, just let that set, and then just go ahead and do the rest of your face. Okay. That's pretty much it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one.